In this episode, we're going to focus on InSpec execution of a control file and profile that we find locally and remotely. First, we'll start with those files on our local workstation, and then we'll show you how you can retrieve them from a URL, the supermarket, or a compliance server. So let's get started. Let's focus first on a test file or control file found locally on my computer. So in the current directory I'm in, I have a file called default_test.rb. I'm going to run InSpec exec, then the control file name. Now this is going to target my local system and tell me that I need to install a number of things to make sure that I am running Tomcat correctly. Now let's try that profile that we saw within that directory as well. So here's the anatomy of this profile, number of files and things within it. And I'm going to use InSpec exec and then the profile's name, or really the directory of that profile, to run it. So you may find a profile or a number of profiles on the internet that you would like to use that were possibly shared to you. Here's one in particular from the DevSec project. On the DevSec project, you might find one related to Linux or Windows, or in this case, the SSH baseline. This contains a number of controls that verifies your system is running securely. You might download or clone it to your system and then execute it as you did previously, but instead you can use InSpec exec and then specify the URL to the GitHub project. This will execute this profile against whatever target. The Chef Supermarket contains a number of profiles as well. You can use the InSpec Supermarket Profiles command to show all the profiles found on the supermarket. Now, if you wanted to execute, say, the Windows baseline profile found in the supermarket here against a Windows target, you would use InSpec Supermarket exec, then that origin name slash profile name, and then specifying your target. Here, I'm going to use a target targeting a Windows system with WinRM, its username, its host name, and then, of course, its password. So in the same way that we ran InSpec Supermarket to view the profiles, we can do the same thing if we have a compliance server running within our organization. We can run InSpec Compliance Profiles to see the profiles found there, and then InSpec Compliance Exec to execute the profiles against our targets. Now, you may notice from the output here that a number of the controls were executed or possibly skipped. So in this case, I've jumped to another version or instance that I've run the profile. You see that I expected to see no, but got nil for a number of these controls. Now, the problem is that I targeted a remote system, but I didn't have the access to the files that I needed. So sometimes it becomes important that if your user does not have access to files, that you can get access to them using the sudo flag. So I'm going to include the sudo flag here, and a number of the skipped controls will now appear as failures or successes. So here, a marked change from the previous. I see that I've got zero skipped controls, a lot more failures, which means a lot more work to do. You can run multiple profiles and controls, both locally and remotely, against a target. Here, I'm going to execute the Tomcat profile and then also the DevSec SSH baseline versus my local workstation. And I'll see the results of both of those profiles in one scan. If you'd like to learn more about InSpec, watch other videos in this series, or you can find more information at the docs or at our tutorials.